Quezon province, bearing the brunt of Super Typhoon Garudin, where dozens of families had to be evacuated because of strong winds and pouring rain. That's after the province is placed under signal number 5 Sunday. Affected areas include Infanta and Puninyo Island. Disaster officials have been making the rounds in flood-prone villages. Sea travel has also been suspended at the Real Port, and fisherfolk advised to avoid the seas for now.
Mahirap din po dahil din po naman yung aking asawa po nasa Maynila. Nagtatrabaho po, di kami lang po dalawa sa aming bahay. Ako po yung dito na pumunta. Ako po yung kinakabanay sa aking bata, sa aking mga pamangkin.
Last 2 years, I think, ay kami na ano ng Ulysses. Ay kami talaga po yung doon ay abot na abot ang basa lahat ng gamit. Talagang nandun na yung takot.
Pinakamalaki po ng evacuees natin nasa Barangay Dinahikan. No, ito po yung coastal barangay, pinakamalaking populasyon at vulnerable po sila sa storm surge.
Meanwhile, in Camarines Norte, around 100 tourists were stranded in Calaguas Island after the Coast Guard implemented a no-sailing policy. Hundreds are also currently staying in various evacuation centers in the province. Travelers were also stranded at the Matmo port in Sorsogon, as sea travel there was also stopped due to the bad weather. Long lines of trucks and other vehicles were also seen outside the port.
Garudin battered several parts of Isabela Sunday. Our correspondent Haris Julio now joins us for the latest from the province. Haris, what more can you tell us? Good morning.
Good morning, Mike. We are now experiencing a bit of drizzle here, but just a while ago, the sun is already up and the weather is a lot calmer here compared to what we have experienced in the previous hours. Torrential and heavy rains and at times gusty winds were felt here. However, no flooded areas or residents who evacuated have been reported. Main roads and bridges are still passable. Electricity and communication lines are also okay, but class in all school levels was suspended here today. Work in government offices except those involved in the front line and emergency services was also suspended in the whole province. In Nueva Vizcaya, where signal number 3 was hoisted due to Superstorm Garudin, heavy rain was experienced from 4 in the afternoon on Sunday. It was accompanied by strong winds from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock in the evening. According to PDRRMO Nueva Vizcaya, there have been preemptive evacuation in several towns due to the threat of flooding and landslide. A total of 156 families in Alfonso Castañeda, Bagabag, and Bayumbong were brought to evacuation centers, while a family which comprised of 5 individuals in Barangay Catarawan, Casibu, voluntarily went to their relative to take temporary shelter. A landslide was also recorded in Bimaco and Tutota, Casibu, while a part of Nueva Vizcaya Pangasinan Road in Barangay Maliku, Santa Fe, Nueva Vizcaya was temporarily closed as a precautionary measure due to the threat of landslide. PDRMO Nueva Vizcaya also said that power supply was cut in the entire town of Alfonso Castañeda in a village or village in Bayumbong yesterday. Meanwhile, Governor Carlos Padilla suspended classes in all school levels and work in government offices except those in basic health and emergency services. Nueva Vizcaya is now under signal number 2. In the province of Quirino, 96 families in the towns of Difun, Aglipay, Madela, Nagdipunan, and Saguday were also preemptively evacuated. Classes in all school levels and work in government offices were also suspended there, except those who are on the front line and emergency services. Meanwhile, Magat Dam continues to monitor the water that is coming from its watershed areas in Nueva Vizcaya and Ifugao. This will be a deciding factor on the volume of water to be discharged. On Saturday, Magat Dam released water in preparation for the heavy rains of Super Typhoon Garudin. In its advisory this morning, Nia Marie said that 162 cubic meters per second, or equivalent to 810 drums of water, is currently being released from the dam. The dam's elevation is at 186.52 meters above sea level, short of 3 meters before it will reach the spilling level of 190 meters above sea levels. Nia Maris reminds residents to avoid going or crossing the Magat River due to possible rise of water level. The public are also reminded that liquor ban and no sale policy are still in effect here in the whole province of Isabela. That's the latest here. Mike, back to you.
Thank you for that update, Harris Julio, and keep safe.